Cody, Dibs is leaving you a present. So when I got stuck yesterday, that means some grease fittings got covered up in mud. That's always handy. Cody's doing my job of greasing this morning, so I went by and opened up all the shields for him. So while Mom fuels and Cody greases, I'm gonna take this time to clean out my cab. Double engine start.
It is so hot outside. It's insane. If all things go smoothly today, we should be able to finish. We have about 100 acres left in this field, and it's all in the mud. So we'll see how long it takes, or if we get stuck again like yesterday. Little update, I was going down and I got to about right here, and then I don't know if y'all can see that, that little spot right there is standing in water and I'm not risking it, so I cut out this little down spot and I'm gonna let Mom pick away at that, and then I'm gonna finish this over here. Here's a perspective on the map. That little triangle, there's a standing water right here, so I'm gonna do this, and then here's where the pivot was that's full of rust that we have to be bouncing across every single time, and then we'll get over here. So Mom is finishing up cleaning up that little circle, and then these turn rows right here have ruts down there, so I'm gonna make a new turn row and hopefully that is drier on this side over, so that way we don't have to turn on the ruts.
No, that was not better. Matter of fact, I think that was worse. I almost got stuck on the turn row down there. So Mom's gonna stay over there in her four-wheel drive combine and go back and forth. And then it's pretty dry on this side of the field, so I'm gonna stay over here.
So Cody's unloading Mom right now because she's on the wet stuff. I also have wet stuff in my pass though, and I almost could barely get through it, but I am at 70%, so I'm just gonna stay right here and dump and then try to go through it again. All the weight in the bin is, all it does is just sink you in the mud, and that's pretty bad on your final drives. So, we're gonna wait on Cody. Productivity is like, right now. We're going through mud and then like cutting the field in a million pieces, and we have to stop when we unload because there's mud right in front of us, so this 100 acres might take all day.
Finish that side. That part of the map is messed up, and then that is underwater, so now we get to go play in it on the other side. I don't know when the last time I had the camera on. It has been non-stop mud this entire time. We finished this half. This was extremely muddy, and then now I kind of, this is a big draw in the middle of the field, and it is extremely wet also, and this is a big low spot. And this is all dry. So I'm gonna work on this, and then Mom's gonna come up here and start trying to get this done. I'm gonna dump into Cody right now because it is kind of wet right here. Like the ground is moist. I'm not cutting ruts, but it's just safe to dump rather than go out there and get frame deep again like yesterday. Thank you.
dirt on my sandwich. We're wrapping it up. I'm excited. So we're wrapping up the final passes here, and then we'll have to go waller in some mud for the final couple acres. But there's a storm actually behind us. That's, you know, shocker. And it's trying to roll in. So right now we're pushing even harder through the mud, trying to get done before that storm catches us. Because that's exactly what we don't need, is a couple inches on top of the mud. And then we'll be stuck here for another week over, I don't know what's left, 20 acres. So we're pushing really hard right now. So I finished the dry stuff, and now we gotta get in the wet stuff to finish the field. I'm trying to take a look. I don't know, you are about to find out with me.
Yeah, I would come down to where I'm at, and then you cut to my left, and I'll clean up this on the right that's still wet.
So Mom said to her left is dry, and to her right is wet. So I gotta go to this end of the field to go around and get on her left. And we're wrapping up this field. There's probably 5-10 acres left. Saves so much time doing a little spin at the end just to clean off your sickle bar, because we have to clean up these headers and combines before we move them. I'm gonna raise my rail up, that way we can clean these headers out. And also, if you roll the center link out all the way, you can get in between this crevice right here. There's gonna be a bunch of straw. Right, you can see some right there.
Yeah, that likes to pick up straw.
You can also clean off these feeder houses and all of this and that. Also, if you have hydraulic fore and aft feeder house, roll that forward too, because there's a whole bunch of stuff down in there that you gotta get.
But yeah, we're done cutting, but the day is not over. We still have to clean these machines and take them back to the yard. That was really sweaty and dirty and nasty. We're about to go to the yard. We made it back to the yard. I don't know if we're loading equipment tonight or if we're doing that tomorrow. I guess we'll find out.
There's not much to do inside the cab other than maybe take the iPad out and maybe pour out Dibs's water bowl. And then I have to take my antenna off of my ceiling. And that's really about it.
Since I have a global audience, if anyone can tell me what these are, I'll be surprised.
Unless you're from South Texas. They tend to stick to your pants. Mom has nice leather interior. Must be nice.
Ooh, her mounting setup is a little crooked though. Oh, I was sitting on a sticker. Okay, so I'm in Mom's combine. I have to go pick up the... There's mosquitoes everywhere. I'm in Mom's combine. I have to go pick up the extra tire that we carry around in case we have a blowout. Tight squeeze. So we call this 18-wheeler the 88 because it's an 88 model. Clever name, right? This leather seat is like, it feels smaller. My cloth one, I feel like it contours my back, and this one is like straight. I don't know, it's kind of weird. I prefer a cloth until it gets hot outside, and then I want an AC seat. But other than that, like in the winter, cloth is just fine. I don't need a heated seat. I kind of like the leather steering wheel though. That's kind of nice.
We gotta unscrew these antennas.
So there's a couple things to do before you load it on the trailer. One is take the antenna off. Two is latch all the doors. I think that's it.
So there's this little latch in here. You pull this pin, you push this up like that, and you put the pin back in. It can't come off.
So if your combine has duals, this one has singles. You'll have to take the duals off. Some people haul it with duals on. Last year, this combine had duals on it. We just switched to singles. That's why it has a long ladder. We took the duals off. That was also a part of, before we loaded it on the trailer, thing to do. But this one has singles, so you don't have to do anything with the tires, which is really nice. Next is the grain cart though. So Cody's going to get the attachment that's laying on the ground right here. That'll use the drawbar to pick up the grain cart. You'll see why in a little bit. So we got Mom's combine and this combine ready to load up. When Dad gets back, then we will load everything up and start hooking hoppers behind the combines. Or header trailers behind the combines. I don't know. He hasn't made up his mind yet. So we got that combine loaded over there. I have the windshield cover and I'm gonna go put that on. Done with the first one. And they're gonna do the second one. So me and Mom are gonna do the windshield cover, and then Dad, John, and Cody are gonna do the chains. Combine loaded. We still have to swing in the ladder, and then we gotta go hook the dolly up to the hopper and then pull it behind this one and then connect the combine trailer to the hopper. We're checking blinkers right now. Normally, if your dolly is not big enough, your trailer's sitting more like right here, and you have to take that boot off, that black piece, otherwise it'll jab into the tarp. But ours is long enough, so we don't have to take that boot off. Everyone wanted move day, so tomorrow's move day. We'll be taking this 18-wheeler, that 18-wheeler, our service trailer, and our fuel trailer. And that'll be it for this video. Thank you all for watching, and I'll see y'all tomorrow. We're moving home tomorrow and then coming back the same day to take the second load, because it takes two loads to move. So thank y'all for watching, and I'll see y'all tomorrow.